Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Jimmy, and today we're going to be doing a review on Shiki. Originally, Shiki was a novel series written by a guy named Fukiana Ono, which probably destroying your name, so sorry. It was published by Shinacha. I wrote it down. I don't really know how to say it, but it was in 1998 anyway, so. The first announcement of the anime series was in 2009, in December of 2009, and I was reading up on it, and apparently Aniplex had something going on. I don't know, they were doing it, but then they weren't doing it or something, so not really sure about that, but yeah. And just to cover all the bases so that I don't get copyrighted, first of all, it's licensed by Funimation, the DVD version and the Blu-ray version. So just to tell you, in case you didn't know, this side of me, there's a little space here that I'm opening up. I might have some videos there while I'm talking or something like that, because I don't know how good the quality is going to be, so if I have some videos there, that just means the quality wasn't good enough for a 720, you know, HD for you guys. So to start off my little review here, I have it written down, and we're going to start off with the animation of the show. The animation of the show was really solid, and there was almost no parts when it went, like, super sketchy or it went really intense. It was always a solid, like, good, solid animation. So other than the hair, which kind of freaked me out at some points, I give the animation an 8.5. And yes, I did just look at my paper when I said that. Alright, we're going to go into our second thing, which is the plot. I gave the plot an 8 out of 10, and the reason why I gave it an 8 out of 10 is because in the beginning, which I'm not going to spoil it for you, the pandemic thing that is going around the village, they make it so strange, like, that you never know what it could be, and there's so many variables that just make it so weird, and, like, just that opening, and that, it was, like, such a strong opening, it gave the plot like a really thick start to, you know, bring people in. Alright, so I'm gonna give you a little spoiler just because I wanted to tell you something. And so as long as my hand is on screen, there will be spoilers. Okay? 1, 2, 3. Okay. The fact that they're vampires and the fact that they're the Japanese version of vampires is cool. And it was just really interesting, as in, like, the way the Japanese portray vampires. Which also was interesting because their fangs are, like, they're not the teeth, they're kind of behind the teeth. I don't know if I'll have a clip of that, but they're kind of behind the teeth and not, like, the teeth. Which was really interesting. So now we're gonna move on to the characters. I gave the characters an 8.8 out of 10. Reason being, there wasn't a main character. That might seem like a crazy out there fantasy for some people, but there was no main character. And when you go to the wiki and all that stuff, they say, like, there's two main characters, blah, blah, blah. For any instance, it was interesting because the first episode they followed a character, and then the second episode they followed a different character. And you kind of expect the main character to be Megumi, which is the girl. You expect her to be the main character, but then the second episode, it's like, no, she's not the main character. So then you're like, oh, okay. Needless to say, that always kept it interesting. So the other characters in the show, which he's sort of a side character, his name's Toru, and he has this sort of, spoilers, he has this kind of love with another character. And in the end, it really just, I mean, spoilers, hands up, spoilers. I think they could have done a little bit more in the end with the two of their storylines, because it just kind of cut off, and they were just dead. So, So last thing I want to say about the characters is the two characters, Natsuno and Megumi. Which, Natsuno is one of the secondary, like, he's a main character, but not the main character. And Megumi is sort of a secondary character. And so Megumi loves Natsuno, but Natsuno, like, hates her for some reason. And he doesn't talk to her. Yet, he'll talk to the girl that's, like, next to him, like, the other girl on the show. Like, okay, that makes sense. And the other thing is, Natsuno's name, he has two names. One of his names is Yuki. And so, Megumi has pink hair, and she said Yuki at one point. And so, just my mind, because I've seen that, what's it called? Mariah and Nikki, I've seen that. And so, it flashed in my head when she started saying it. I was like, oh.
Yuki-kun.
So after scarring all of you with that, I'm going to go on to this special. The special for this anime review is going to be about the battle for right and wrong and God versus spoilers, God versus vampires, and all the things that all the characters went through, and like the morality switch. And I mean, honestly, I'll never look at spoilers, vampires, ever again, the same way. Also, I really liked Seishin and Sunika's, like, storylines. Kind of gave, like, a little backstory, as it could have been something, but you didn't really go into the backstory, which was good, because, yeah, it could have been, like, a freaking long series where it goes into all the backgrounds of everyone, which it didn't, so that was good. Seishin for the win! Okay, overall, I give Shiki an 8.43 repeating. Well, everyone, thanks for watching, and, you know, rate, subscribe, whatever, rate is not a thing anymore, like it, subscribe, see you in the next video. What is wrong with this hair?